How's it going, beautiful people? I'm here. We're here. Yet another day that we're existing in this earth. We must continue to push positivity. That'll probably be the beginning of a lot of videos that I make in the future, because ultimately, like, if you only listen to like 30 seconds of this entire thing, like, at least in the first couple seconds, you get like some really positive shit, all right? Like, that's all I want for people to do, is take positivity and put it back into the world. Like, honestly, I don't care how you do it, like, as long as it's done. As long as it's done with the right intention. Because I know people are going to take your intentions, or they're going to take your actions and not understand your intentions. And sometimes your intentions can be pure. So sometimes, though you have pure intentions, people may take them the wrong way. So that's okay. We're just going to get past that. You're just going to do what your heart tells you to do. You know, I was just thinking to myself earlier today, it's just like, man, trust and transparency are things that require a lot of effort. So in order for me to have a trustworthy environment, I must put out that energy so that people can see it and not want to deviate from that. I think a lot of people are followers. So if they see a person that's doing the right thing and it looks good, then they're probably going to want to do the right thing too. It's all about what looks attractive to people. It's all about what brings people here and what keeps them here. So do something and do it to the best of your ability. And for me, that's pushing positivity. That's staying calm. That's multiplying the energy that I have within me to better levels so that I can continue to elevate. Like, one thing we can't do as a society or as an individual is like stay stagnant. We must always be prepared for the next day, because ultimately that helps the world become a better place. And knowledge is only passed if you are relinquishing knowledge and you are willing to seek more knowledge. So continue to push positivity and the right people will follow and they will do the same. And then you'll continue a path of love and peace, and you'll make an entire community. And now you have an entire ecosystem of people who love and care about one another. And then they're just continuing to keep making this place beautiful. So again, do what you do to the best of your ability. I pray for you that in some shape or form, positivity is ingrained in that, because that's the type of universe that I want, and that's what I'm going to give to you. So I'm trying to understand myself. I'm trying to better myself. Right now I'm in a place where I just came back from vacation, so I was very reflective. I was so thankful for that experience. It was me and my mom just sitting in Turks and looking out into the abyss of the world and just reflecting on what got us to where we were, so, and where we are. And so a lot of things were discussed, you know. For me personally, like, I know that I came to a lot of grips with who I am and who I want to be. And so I see a lot of things in my future. I just have to continue to keep pushing and fighting for them. I can't allow gravity to weigh me down. I must continue to fight gravity, because the second that my energy gets stopped, then the goal, then the vision that I have for myself isn't fully attained. So I must continue to keep hitting that wall. And that's what I was reflecting on, is the vision, and how do we continue this? How do we make a legacy out of what we've built so far and continue to keep elevating that legacy? So for me personally, it's in the creative spectrum. I have a lot of influence internally, and I know that if I'm able to project that positivity of influence out into the world, I could at least help one person, because so far I've already helped one person. So I just want to continue to keep helping people, and the people that come to me, I pray that we become intertwined spiritually and on a spectrum of peace, because I do want a universe of happiness around me and everywhere. I enjoy this, man. Like sitting back, thinking in Turks, talking about relationships that I've witnessed and relationships that I've been through. You know, it's interesting, you know. I see the same traits in a lot of relationships. I continue to keep repeating patterns, and I'm trying to deviate from the patterns that I've created to build a new pathway for myself. And so right now, I'm trying to wean away from energy that doesn't benefit me fully, or energy that doesn't benefit production. I need to continue to be in a place where I feel whole, and the things that make me whole are being able to create my visions. I feel like the second that I'm not able to create a vision that I have, then I start to feel as though I'm not living out my life the way that I want to. It's a mentality that's rooted in selfishness. It's absolutely rooted in selfishness. So it's weird because I'm selfish with that mentality, but I still want to provide positivity. It's like I want to be positively known for giving positivity to the point where that is a sufficient way of life for me. I don't have a monetary value on that. I just want to be able to live comfortably, safe, with the proper amenities for survival. If I can do that based on my creativity, then to me that is a success. I don't want to set my goal for any number, anything that is quantifiable outside of sustainable life. If I can acquire sustainable life through my creativity, then that's exactly the path that I would love to have. I feel like now I'm kind of living my life in a way that's catering to others' creativity, and I'm not really focused on my creativity. And I think I've made a pattern of that throughout my life, constantly putting more energy into someone else's creativity versus my own. So that's the beauty of me moving and placing myself in an environment that is different, and I'm alone because I need to be able to focus inward and try to manifest the creative ideas that I have in my mind. I'm very thankful for this opportunity because I feel like with every step that I take, there's a affirmation that's being shown to me that I'm going on the right path. And those are the things that keep me up at night, that let me know that what I'm doing is fulfilling enough for my soul. And so I understand the path that it that 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 that's on this journey, and I understand that the risks that are associated with taking a creative path, because that involves a lot of things coming out of your own pocket. It requires a lot of misunderstandings on a lot of sides. It requires transparency, and with transparency on camera, you tend to put yourself in positions that may leave you vulnerable. You may feel misrepresented, even if it's words that you physically said out of your own mouth. You may feel like I was in the right state of mind, or I didn't fully think that thought out before I put it onto record. And so for me, I understand those risks, but I'm still willing to work through them because I feel like I've taken enough time personally to understand the best way I can how to interpret my thoughts on camera. So I pray that whoever is on the other end of the camera, they can receive this information and understand that there's love. So yeah, I was in Turks, understanding myself, understanding my mom, understanding her relationships, asking a lot of questions that I didn't ask before. You know, speaking more openly about the things that I witnessed as a kid, because like I'm starting to realize, you know, everyone's a living projection. And so when I'm thinking about the projections that I do, I have to look at the stuff that I witnessed and what made me the person that I am today. And when I do that, I reminisce on things that I saw as a kid, and who not better to speak to than your mom about these things. So we spoke very in-depthly, and I got a much better understanding for her as I try to every time that we connect, because I don't want any time to go by where I could have had a question or a conversation that I had the capabilities of having that we didn't have. So I'm so thankful for these moments, because I know it's a privilege, and everyone's not able to get these moments. Everyone's not able to speak to their mom and be in a different environment away from outside stressors to really decompress and have like a fully just level conversation. So I just always want to be thankful for these moments, because I know that a lot of people aren't able to have those moments. So I hit the ground running. You know, I go to Virginia, and I'm starting to develop my mentality on how I want to conduct myself. And I come to grips that a lot of the relationships that I've had, I looked at them from a perspective that has been changed now. It's an unfortunate thing sometimes, and sometimes it's a positive thing. For me, I believe it's a positive thing, because now I can look at things from a perspective of what it actually is versus thinking one thing and knowing another. So I'm thankful for truths revealing themselves to me. I pray that relationships continue to stay the same, and that there is no complete disconnect. I do feel like there is some form of disconnect, just because when truths are withheld and not spoken about, or when actions are done that could be viewed as disrespect, that changes the dynamic of a relationship. Whether you guys mend or not, that experience still occurred. So therefore, you have to move in the future with these experiences under your belt. So now that these experiences have been had and truths have been revealed, things will be different. I pray that things aren't so drastically different that ties are ruined, that friendships are diminished. Because I want to continue to keep my circle plentiful. But I do feel that when people are close to you and they provide a certain level of misfortunes, then you may have to look at them from a different perspective than you did before. And so that's kind of what I'm dealing with, is like, man, who do I trust in this world? Like, who can I call on and fully believe in? And I feel that there are people that I can do that with. And it's just unfortunate that things had to occur for people to see the things that they saw, you know? In due time, I pray we get past everything that we experience. You know, talking to yourself is kind of interesting, because like I can do this so easily when there's other people in the room, but when it's just you and the camera, it's kind of hard, because you're just stuck in your own brain. And there's no place you can run. Like, I can't run off of another person's idea. Like, I have to sit in my thought and I have to like experience it and I have to work through it. And the only person you can fake it with is, you know, other people. You can't fake it with yourself, though, you know? Like, when you look in the mirror, when you're in this room alone with just a camera, you have to look at what you do. So when I look at what I do, and when I look at the person that I was, I do feel that my mind did wrong. Even though my body, my actions weren't wrong, I feel like in my mind I was doing wrong. And so I don't like to compare, but I just feel like, who am I to judge another person's actions when my mind was just as wrong, if not, you know, it was just as wrong. So that's the part of me that keeps me level. It keeps me constantly keeping people in my circle, even though they may have possibly done an outward wrong, because I know who I am as a person and I know what stopped me from making the full action. You know, I know that it was still in my head, and had I not had that blocker, I probably would have done the exact same thing. So because I understand that about myself, it's hard for me to completely cut people out of my life, because you don't want to cut someone out of your life, especially if you know that you've thought some crazy stuff too, even though you didn't do it. Like, it's just hard when you're really being honest with yourself. You're like, okay, they're fucked up, but am I not fucked up? Like, am I perfect? Like, okay, so what do you do? And it's like, what I do is I think about a lot of fucked up stuff, you know, like I think about it. It goes through my head, and then it sits there for a minute. I think about it, and then I process it, and then I get out of it, you know? But a lot of people don't have that extra process part. They just think it sits, and then they do it. Like, the process part is missing for a lot of people. So I can't judge another person, because they haven't understood how to process that. And so for me, I just look at these people who need more time to process things as more time to understand. And just such as myself, I still have more time I have to understand. So for me, I just accept what it is. And I understand that because they're still learning how to process things, and so am I. See, it's constant. This is a constant thing. Like, if you're in my brain, this is me bringing you in my brain. Like, I'm telling you, this is the way. It's in and out. It's in and out. It's man, but man, but man, but man, but man, but man. So that leaves me just kind of fair ground. It's just like, whatever you tell me, man. Like, you did that. Cool. You know, thank you for telling me. You know, you could have never told me. You know what I'm saying? Like, you could have held that within your heart and just looked at me in my eyes every day and not told me. You know, like, I have to respect the person who looks someone in the eyes despite the wrongs that they did, and they tell the truth still, because that's the hard part. Like, it's easy to do it. It's easy to think it. It's harder to sit in front of your truth and knowing that you could possibly get judged for your truth and continue to go through with it, you know? Like, that's the hard stuff. So if you do that, despite the action, I'm going to respect it. And that probably will build more trust, because at least I know that if you do wrong, you have the wherewithal to understand that you're wrong and try to make best out of it. And I respect anybody on the earth who does that. I respect you. Like, for good, period. Like that's who I constantly aspire to be. That's who I hope that people view me as. And that's the energy that I want to emulate and teach the next generation to grow up with. So thank you to every single person who takes the time out of their day to step in front of their issues and address it like it is and try to make best out of it. Like, you can't change everything, but you can start right now to make the best out of the situation. So if that's the type of energy that you got, man, please come around me. Like, that's all I want around me are people who want to make the best out of their situation, period. Like, I don't want negativity. I need to be around positivity because that's the energy I'm giving out. And I feel like if you come around me and you're negative, like, I'm going to just continue to hammer you a positivity and just keep hammering it. And you're just going to be like, holy crap, man, this dude's freaking positive. I either have to get away from this dude or be positive, because that's the type of energy that I want to just continue to manifest and create until it's one just humongous bubble of positivity. So thank you. Thank you for everyone who's trying to be positive. Like, this is me just coming and giving thanks to those who are positive. Continue to keep doing what you're doing, because that's inspiring me to continue to do what I'm doing. And hopefully I'm inspiring someone else to continue to do what they're doing. So positivity, positivity, positivity. One love.